then everybody in that little circle right there gets to see a total solar eclipse. A lunar eclipse is when the moon's over here, and the sun is now casting the Earth's shadow that the moon's moving through. So the moon's in the Earth's shadow, and this is a lunar eclipse. All right? Which one of these things do you think happens more often?
Lunar.
The lunar happens more often because the moon's casting the Earth's casting a way bigger shadow for the moon to move through, and everybody on this side of the Earth can see the lunar eclipse. The solar eclipse is a tiny little shadow, and only people right in that shadow can see it. All right? How often do we get the orbital geometry such that the moon is over here? How often does that happen?
Once every 70.
Once a month.
Once a month.
Once a month. Okay. So this is your new moon over here, and then this is your full moon. Okay. So you can only get total lunar eclipses at full moon, and you're only going to get solar eclipses at new moon. Okay. But if this happens once a month, then why are they so rare? Each spot on the Earth gets a total solar eclipse about every 350 years. Okay, so why is it so rare? Well, it turns out that you need a lot more going on than just this orientation. This is step one. There's a lot more things we have to contend with to end up with a total solar eclipse. So let's talk about why that is. And what do these things look like from the Earth? Just, you've just seen the solar eclipse, right? So the disk of the moon comes in front of the sun and then eventually blocks it out if you're in totality, or if you're in partial eclipse, like if you stayed in Florida, you saw this.
I like the ring.
It is, but 90% and 100% is different universes, right? So the lunar eclipse is very different because the moon doesn't go away. It's just passing through the Earth's shadow, so it just kind of gets red, but it doesn't disappear from the sky, right? It happens a lot more often. Okay, and there's different types of solar eclipses, okay? There's a partial eclipse, which is what you saw for the rest of the United States. There's an annular eclipse where everything's lined up just right, but the moon isn't quite big enough in the sky to block out the sun, so we still have this ring of sun left over. And then there's the total eclipse where everything worked out just right. All right, that's the really, really rare one. So why would we get an annular eclipse? Well, who knows what the parallax effect is? Who's bigger here? The squirrel or the people?
Squirrel.
The squirrel, okay? Why is he bigger?
Closer,
okay? So when things are closer to you, they appear larger. That's what the parallax effect is. So the same thing happens with the moon, all right? The moon's orbit around the Earth is not a circle. If it were a circle, the moon would always be the same distance from us, and it would always look the same size. But it's not a circle. It's an ellipse. It has an eccentricity. So there's some points in its orbit called perigee, where it's closer to the Earth, and it looks bigger. And there's some points in its orbit when it's farther away called apogee, so it looks smaller. Mm-hmm. Okay? When you get everything lined up just right for the eclipse, but the moon is at apogee, it's farther away, it's just not quite big enough now to block out the sun, and we end up with an annular eclipse. So it lined up just right, but oh no, it's not big enough to fully block it. All right? Now, which is bigger, the moon or the sun?
The sun.
By a little or a lot? A lot, okay? But when we look up in the sky, they look almost exactly the same size. So it's a really unique situation that we have on this planet where our giant star is exactly the right distance away based on its size, that it looks in the sky almost exactly the same as the moon, so much so that the sort of small variation of the moon's orbit can either fully block the sun or not block the sun. So it's really rare to have a situation where you can even experience a solar eclipse at all. So the other thing we have to contend with is the inclination of the moon's orbit, all right? So the moon's orbit is tilted relative to the Earth. So sure, we get the moon over here once a month, but sometimes the shadow it's casting is too low, and sometimes it's too high because of the tilt of this orbit. If it weren't tilted, we'd have a much better chance. We'd get them much more often. But that tilt is one of the things that really gets us. And when that happens, we get a partial eclipse, or usually no eclipse at all right? It either partly blocks it, most of the time it just doesn't block it at all. So that's the different types of eclipses and why we get them. So why are these total solar eclipses so rare? All right? You have to get the right orientation of the Earth, Moon, Sun system, but that happens once a month. That's not that hard, all right? But the moon's orbit is inclined, so we have to be in the right spot on the moon's orbit such that the shadow lines up on the Earth. The moon's orbit is eccentric, so the moon is different distances from us. It appears different sizes. We need it to be the squirrel up in the front of the picture and not the people in the back of the picture. And even when you get everything right, the moon's shadow on the Earth is so tiny, and only the people in that tiny little shadow get to see the total solar eclipse. And what's more, most of the time that shadow is over the water, just because the Earth is mostly ocean. Right? So let me show show you some movies.